Good afternoon, SHS. Welcome to the Salem Show from our Washington County Community Foundation studios at Salem High School. I'm your host, Sydney Brown.
And I'm your other host, Sydney Burton.
Welcome to the SID Show, where you'll hear everything Sydney related.
Wait, what?
Yeah, I thought we'd do something fun today and talk about us and other famous Sydneys.
Hold on, I don't think.
You know, like the hockey player Sidney Crosby, TikTok star Sydney Dunk, reality star Sydney Starr, and many, many more.
Oh, I hope not.
What? You don't think that's a great idea?
It's not that it isn't a great idea. We just need to cover what's happening at SHS and beyond.
I guess, but I like my idea better.
Anyways, let's get started and go straight to announcements.
Attention, grades 9 through 11. Are you interested in being a veterinarian? Check out Purdue Summer Camp. Information is in your Google Classroom.
Congrats to Gabby Hypes. Her name was drawn from Dry High Y members for a free pizza.
I hope she shares with her friends, a particular senior I know.
The January scholarship list is now available. Check the 2023 Google Classroom, your email, your English classroom, and student services. There are some local scholarships this month. Make sure you apply.
I'm all over that.
Hold up. Is this how it's going to be today?
What?
You know. I read all the announcements and you just comment on them.
Sounds like a plan.
Great. Let's move on. Are you interested in learning about military benefits and careers? Or are you interested in learning what you can do to support deployed Indiana Guardsmen and military vets within our community? If so, see Mr. Lee in room 233 to discuss starting a military-based club at SHS.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Jeez. Anyone interested in doing the Polar Plunge for Special Olympics needs to get registered online and start collecting donations. The plunge will be at Deem Lake on February 11th. See Ms. Phipps in room 16 if you have any questions.
Hey, Sydney.
Yeah?
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
I see.
I see who?
I see you.
Really? Did you forget to order your Try Y shirt before Christmas? Orders have been reopened. If you want a shirt, see Ms. Martin or an officer this week. Today is the last day to order. Got anything?
Nope.
Well, okay. A little professionalism from you. I like it.
Remember, vending machines are off limits during school hours. If you need a snack, please go to the vending machines before the start of school or after school has let out for the day.
And just your yearly reminder about your Chromebook. Make sure when your Chromebook gets down to 5%, charge it.
Shut down your Chromebook to charge it. This will eliminate most issues in charging Chromebooks.
And winter is here, so be careful with your Chromebook. Make sure you're not leaving your Chromebook out in the cold, because this may harm the screen or interfere with connections.
So speaking of winter, let's head over to Davern for the weather. What's the weather going to be like? I'm hoping the cold stays away, and I see you too.
Sydney.
Sorry.
Thanks, Sydney, and well, Sydney. I'm not Davern, but I still will give you the weather report. Well, you don't need your snow boots, but you will probably need your galoshes a couple of times next week. So let's get to it. Friday, we have a high of 35 and a low of 25 with a 40% chance of snow. And it's Friday the 13th. Saturday, we have a high of 39 and a low of 25. It's partly cloudy. Saturday, we have a high of 47 and a low of 37, and it's National Bagel Day. Monday, we have a high of 49 and a low of 47, with a 40% chance of rain, and it's Martin Luther King Day, so be prepared to not have to come to school. Tuesday, it's a high of 54 and a low of 41, with lots of clouds. Wednesday, we have a high of 55, a low of 49, and a 30% chance of rain, so get your boots out. Thursday, we have a high of 54 and a low of 36, partly cloudy, and it's National Popcorn Day, so eat all you can. Friday, we have a high of 47 and a low of 35 with lots of clouds, and a home basketball game against the Panthers. Now let's pause for a short commercial break and then head over to the community news with Elaine.
What can I give to the Community Foundation? The short answer is practically anything. However, we want to work with you to make sure that you give the gift that is most beneficial for you. We know you want to be generous, but why not also maximize your tax savings while you're at it? Very often, people give cash. However, we can also accept stocks, bonds, life insurance, IRAs, real estate, and even grain, timber, and livestock. But please don't bring your cow to our office. We are happy to work with you to determine the gift that makes the most sense for you.
Thanks, Davin, for the weather forecast. This week for our community news, I would like to highlight the historic Salem Speedway, which has recently changed hands. The Salem Speedway opened its gates in 1947. The track was designed for high-powered, fast cars that on average reach an impressive 140 miles per hour on the straights. The track boasts a unique 33-degree banks designed for these speeds. Notable names who have raced at the Salem Speedway include Jeff Gordon, Mark Martin, Tony Stewart, and Jimmy Johnson. 12 to 15 events are held at the track each year. As of December 30th, the Salem Speedway has officially changed ownership. The new owner, Nick Bohannon, a Southern Indiana native, is excited to see what the future holds for the track. Bohannon is planning on making a few improvements. He said, "I definitely want to clean the place up, paint it, do something with the signage out front. There are improvements that I want to make to the pavement, the pit area, lighting, infield concessions, infield restrooms, and the scoreboard. It will be a process of getting those done over the next several years." The Salem Speedway has been a staple of Washington County since its opening, and we hope with this new ownership will come good things. Now I'll throw it to Brayden at the Hoosier Upland Sports Desk.
Thanks, Elaine. Now let's get right into sports from the Hoosier Upland Sports Desk. The swim team is doing relatively well with a loss for both teams on Tuesday versus North Harrison, a win for the boys team on Thursday last week versus Corden, and a win for both teams on the 29th of December versus Scottsburg and Lanesville, which also happened to be their senior night. Good job, swimmers. The Lions basketball team is struggling with nonstop losses recently. Last Friday, they played the number 1 and 1A Orleans Bulldogs on the road, and they just couldn't get the win in a tight 37-43 game. The next night, they played Crawford County, and it was a tug-of-war game for the lead. With 2 seconds left and high hopes for the Lions with a 2-point lead, Crawford County scored and pushed the game into overtime. It was then that the Lions struggled the most, with Crawford County gaining a lead almost every time the Lions were on defense. They travel to Scottsburg tonight, then Big Cat Weekend will take place next weekend. They will host the Corden Central Panthers Friday, and then travel to Ramsey to face the North Harrison Cougars. Hopefully, they will be back on the winning track soon. Good luck, guys. The Lady Lions basketball team has been doing better as of late, with a 2-5 record since break. They traveled to New Albany December 21st and lost a close 123-26. Then they traveled to Triton Central for their tourney. They had an overtime loss to the eventual tourney champs and host school, the Triton Central Tigers, 41-40. The next day, they beat the Jacksonville Rebels 47-45. Then later that night, they lost to an athletic and fast South 24-42. Last Tuesday, the Lady Lions were back at home, and this time they hosted the number 12 in 1A Borden Lady Braves. The game went back and forth all night, and overtime was needed to decide this game. Unfortunately, the Lady Lions couldn't pull off the win and lost 53-54. Then MSC rival, the Silver Creek Lady Dragons, crawled in Brooks Memorial Gymnasium last Saturday for a mid-afternoon game. The Lady Lions hung with the Lady Dragons for most of the game, but were turned away in the fourth quarter and lost 32-52. Then Monday night, the South Central Lady Rebels came charging in. The Lady Lions pulled out a victory 53-40. They played the Warriorettes last night at the Pressure Cooker in Scottsburg. We'll bring you the highlights to that game next time. They played Charlestown next week on the 19th and Sydney night next Saturday against Mitchell. And then they will finish the regular season at Austin on the 26th. Good luck, ladies, and keep putting the ball in the bucket. Wrestling has been doing well with a win against Providence this past Monday and placing second in the Super 6 wrestling meet. They had a match yesterday against East Washington, and they have a match tomorrow against Southwestern. More on those matches later. The NFL has been pretty interesting lately. Of course, we should probably start with the elephant in the room, DeMar Hamlin. In the Bills game last week, DeMar Hamlin went in to block T. Higgins, who then lowered his shoulder to try to get an extra yard or two. His shoulder struck Hamlin's chest, approximately where his heart is, and he went into cardiac arrest. He's transported to the hospital, and he is being treated there. We pray his recovery is easy. Next, we have the playoff knockouts, and if you are a fan of any of these teams, you should consider new ones. In the AFC, the Houston Texans, Indianapolis Colts, Denver Broncos, Cleveland Browns, Las Vegas Raiders, New York Jets, Tennessee Titans, New England Patriots, and Pittsburgh Steelers didn't make the playoffs. In the NFC, the Chicago Bears, Arizona Cardinals, Los Angeles Chargers, Atlanta Falcons, Carolina Panthers, New Orleans Saints, Green Bay Packers, Washington Commanders, and Detroit Lions were kicked out of the playoffs. The New York Rangers continue to disappoint me as they somehow lost to the New Jersey Devils 3-4. They almost made up for it by beating the Colorado Wilds, but I don't hate the Wilds like I hate the Devils. If you're a fan of the Maple Leafs, you can rejoice as they beat the Red Wings. Being my second favorite team, the Bruins haven't let me down as much as the Rangers have this season. In fact, they demolished the Anaheim Ducks 7-1. A few games coming up that I will be watching include the Sharks versus Oilers games tonight, the Tampa Bay Lightning versus the St. Blues tomorrow. That's it for Sports Minute at the Hoosier Uplands Sports Desk. We'll be back after this short commercial break.
Shop local at Lynx Clothing and Shoes. Lynx offers a wide variety of clothing. Looking for a nice outfit for the night? Lynx has it. Need a nice pair of shoes to go with it? Lynx has it. Lynx doesn't just offer nice clothes, though. They also provide all your local sports team gear. Shop for Salem, Eastern, or West Washington merchandise. Is your child missing any sports gear for his or her game? Lynx has it. With the wide selection and stylish and comfortable clothing and shoes, all your sports gear and equipment needs, along with the reasonable prices and a central location in the heart of downtown Salem, Indiana, there is no reason you shouldn't stop by and shop at Lynx Clothing and Shoes.
Thanks, Braden, for the Sports Minute from the Hoosier Upland Sports Desk. It's really a wonder that we have been doing the Sports Minute. Speaking of the wonders, let's wander into Monday Matters. Wonder is a magical thing. Wonder doesn't know time and space, or the calendar. For that matter, wonder is energy, a feeling, a force that lifts our spirit and invites us to feel things bigger than life. It takes wonder to see the world around us and ask questions instead of reacting in fear and disappointment. It takes wonder to trust that there are endless possibilities in life, even when we don't know exactly what's in the future. And it takes wonder to fully own how much you matter and know that you have special gifts the world needs right now. So this week, we want you to feel the wonder. To begin with, Have you ever considered the fact that everything we see in our world, whether a physical state or an achievement, started from a place of wonder? I wonder what it would be like to walk on the moon. This week is about being open to creating more wonder. With a click of the heels and a wave of our wands, let's enjoy the magic feeling of wonder matters. That's all for this week, Monday Matters. Let's head back to the anchors.
Thanks, Finn, for a wonderful Monday Matters. And don't worry, Finn, you'll get used to all the puns.
He probably won't, because I still roll my eyes at them. At least we didn't have a lot, bunch, cluster, collection, bundle, or plethora of alliterations to do. Wait, I see what happened there. Now we are going to do the synonym of words.
I hope not. That would be ridiculous, laughable, absurd, comical, diverting. Hold on, this has to stop.
See, he loves this. Sydney, let's end, finish, complete, close, conclude. Ugh.
Anyways, thank you for tuning in to the Salem Show from the Washington County Community Foundation Studios.
So this will conclude. What, no more synonyms?
Please, don't tempt him.
This concludes our fabulous, fit, phenomenal, first-rate, first episode of Season 10 of The Salem Show.
No, the alliteration is back.
As the show winds down, we would like to remind everyone watching to like and subscribe to our account and streaming channels.
Also, don't forget to check out other social media platforms like Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and TikTok. On these apps, you can view an array of videos and updates about our Salem Lions News Network.
We'll see you next time, and have a great, gold-blooded week, Lions!